السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How are you, my students? Welcome in Quran class. My name is Shaima Bah. I am Quran and Arabic teacher. Inshallah, today we will study together a new Tajweed lesson. The lesson today is about the connection between the letters, العلاقات بين الحروف. In the last class, we studied letters relationships. Neighboring letters in one or two words are four. متماثلان means identical. متقاربان means resembling. متجانسان means similar. متباعدان means unsimilar. Inshallah, we will study together each one from this video and the next videos. Today we will continue in studying متماثلان, identical. The goals from this lesson are four. Number one, know the meaning of متماثلان. Number two, know the format of متماثلان. Number three, know the cases of إدغام متماثلان. Number four, know the cases of izhar mutamathilan. Number five, distinguish between the categories of mutamathilan. Number six, master the pronunciation of mutamathilan. Let's start with definition of mutamathilan. متماثلان means two letters that share the same name, مخرج, articulation point, and categories, and characteristics, like ب and ب. متماثلان means when two letters follow each other and are the same, like كاف and كاف, ها and ها, ألف and ألف. Examples: in a word like سلككم, in two words like اذهب بكتابي. كاف and كاف, يدرككم, ميم and ميم, لهم ما يشاءون. صاد and صاد, قصصناهم. Types of متماثلان are three: صغير, مطلق, and كبير. صغير means minor. صغير means the first letter is silent. The second letter has حركة, like ربحت تجارتهم. مطلق means the first letter has حركة. The second letter is silent, has سكون, like زللتم. كبير means the first letter has ضمة, has حركة. The second letter has حركة, like يعلم ما. Categories of متماثلان are three: minor, major, absolute. صغير, كبير, مطلق. Let's start with the first category, minor identity. متماثلان صغير. The first letter has سكون. The second letter has حركة, like ربحت تجارتهم. اضرب بعصاك, لكم ما سألتم. The rule of minor identity, حكم المتماثلين الصغير, is إدغام. اضرب بعصاك, لكم ما سألتم. إدغام. Yes, it's إدغام. Rule of minor identity: when the first letter is mad, you should make it hard, like الذي يؤمن, آمنوا وعملوا. الذي يوسوس في يوسف. اصبروا وصابروا. Manner that begins with mat. Izhar is applied to both letters. Manner that begins with silent ha, like ma aghna anni maliyah, halaka anni sultaniyah. Both izhar and idgham can be applied. Okay. When applying izhar, make a little pause to differentiate the two letters of ha. Maliyah, halaka. The second category of identity is major identity. متماثلان كبير, like سلككم, تتجافى. The first letter has حركة, the second letter has حركة. فيه هدى, دراهم معدودة. إظهار is applied to both letters, like يعلم ما الشوكة تكون. فيه هدى. Role of major identity is إظهار. Exceptions to major identity rule. Words that have idgham. The first word is ta'manuna, ta'manuna. It's ta'manna. It's exception. Makanani, makanani. It's makanni. أتحاجونني, it's أتحاجوني. نعم ما, it's نعم ما. تأمرونني, it's تأمروني. Let's go to the third category of متماثلان. It's absolute identity, متماثلان مطلق. Like ننسخ, أتممت, تمسسه, أنزل لكم. مطلق no, أنزل لكم no. No. Absolute إظهار is applied to both letters. شققنا. The first letter has حركة, the second letter has سكون. زللتم. فأحيينا. Application. صغير, please try to read the next example. Can you read? Please try. Try to read. Yes. وقل لعبادي. Don't forget إدغام. Try to read. أينما يوجهه. Please try to read. يدرككم. Try. واذكر ربك. كبير. Major. Please try to read. إنه هو. ونذكرك كثيرا. Try. فيه هدى. إنك كنت بنا بصيرا. مطلق. Absolute. Please try to read. Can you read? Yes. للهدى. Try. قصصناهم. الأنثيين. تمسسه. Now, let's develop your listening skills. Please look at this example. What can you notice? This is idgham. مثلان صغير, مثلاً صغير in which silent ra was كر ra has سكون should be merged in متحرك ra ربك. Please repeat after me the correct pronunciation. واذكر ربك. Please repeat. Repeat. Yes. واذكر ربك. Repeat. That's the right. But the wrong is واذكر. واذكر. No. Look at the example. This is إدغام مثلاً صغير in which silent fa should be merged in متحرك fa. Please repeat after me the right pronunciation. فلا يسرف في القتل. That's the right. But the wrong is فلا يسرف في القتل. No, wrong. You should make إدغام, not إظهار. قل لو this is إدغام مثلاً صغير in which silent lam should be merged in متحرك lam like this. Please repeat after me. قل لو كان. That's the right, but the wrong is قل لو كان. This is إدغام مثلاً صغير in which the first silent letter should be merged in the second متحرك letter. Please repeat after me. تسطع عليه. But the wrong is تسطع عليه. Now, please, I want to test your knowledge. Are you ready? Yes, you. You, yes. Are you ready or no? Okay. I will ask you three questions. The first group of questions is true or false. The second, choose the correct answer. The third, listen and choose the correct pronunciation. The first one, true or false. Please tell me, true or false. فأحيينا. In this world, the rule of ya is izhar. متماثلان كبير. فأحيينا. The first letter has haraka, the second letter has sukoon. It's kabir, huh? It's saghir or mutlak or kabir. Which one? Kabir? Yes, it's kabir. Yes. Fihi hudan. In this word, the rule of ha is izhar. Mutamathilan kabir. Kabir. Fihi ha has haraka. Hodan, ha has haraka also. Kabir, two letters, both of them has haraka? No. Kabir means the first letter has haraka, the second letter has sukun. Ha, it's a kabir? No, it's wrong. Good. Saqaqna, in this word, is an example for idgham mithlan saghir. It's a saghir, shaqaqna. The first letter has haraka, the second letter has sukun. It's a saghir? No, it's a kabir. That means that's wrong. Mutamathilan means the two letters share the same exact point and sifa, like ba and ba. Sure, right. Mutamathilan means the two neighboring letters are silent. Right or wrong? No, wrong. لكم ما سألتم. In this example, the rule of ميم is إدغام with غنة. Right or wrong? لكم ما سألتم. إدغام with غنة. Yes, it's إدغام with غنة. Good. إدغام must only be applied in the case of مثلان مطلق absolute. إدغام must only be applied, no, absolute. Absolute means two letters has حركة. It's not إدغام in absolute. In مطلق, it's إظهار. إدغام is wrong. Kyoto is the second group of questions. Choose the correct answer. Please tell me which one is right. Which of the following doesn't have إدغام متماثلين؟ Which one؟ قل لكم، تسطع عليه، الذي يوسوس. Doesn't have إدغام متماثلين. إدغام متماثلين means the first letter has إدغام. Doesn't have إدغام متماثلين. إدغام. قل لكم it has because the first letter has سكون, second letter has حركة. تصي عليه the same. الذي يوسوس no it's إظهار because mad. Yes, good. The term متماثلان means, متماثلان means what? Both letters have the same exact point and صفة. Both letters have the same exact point but differ in their صفة. The letters have the different exact points but the same صفة. Which one is right? Which one? Huh? Yes, the first one. Both letters have the same exact point and صفة. Let's go to the second group of questions. Listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Please listen and choose. Number one. اضرب بعصاك. Number two. اضرب بعصاك. Which one is right? The first one. Yes. Please look and listen. Number one. قل لعبادي. Number two. قل لعبادي. Which one is right? Number one. Yes. قل لعبادي. Number one. لهم ما يشاءون. Number two. لهم ما يشاءون. Which one? The first one or the second one? The second one. Yes, very good. Number one. واذكر ربك. Number two. واذكر ربك. Which one is right? Number two. واذكر ربك. You finished the exam. You finished your test. Congratulations! I am proud of you. Now it's time to leave you. That's great to see you today. Please, if this video is useful for you, don't forget to make like, share, and subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.